Hello everyone, JC Fisher here. I'm just wanting to say a few words to tell you a little bit about the paint party that's coming up, how that came about. So excited to have that because it's one last chance to honor not only my good friend, but Rich's good friend, Clinton, Retrobuilt, Frank, all the guys that were really good friends with Jerry. We're gonna have this paint party and kind of all get together as some of his best friends and do one last project. And that project is not only with the people that he cared about and cared about him, but it's with two cars that he was personally on a mission to finish for me. We had started on my old gray 66 Chevy truck that I got when I was 15. And I took my mom to her first prom and my senior prom in. And the other car is of course the 67 Firebird that was my good friend Gary Richner's drag car. So he was working on both of those vehicles when he got into the accident, which that tragic accident that happened, and then almost a year after that he was gone. But he will live on forever in our memories and in our hearts, because Jerry was just an awesome guy. He deeply affected me. I was only in his life for about 4 years and he was in mine, but I'll always think of Jerry and everything I do. And this last paint party is just a fun event for all of us to get together to throw down some paint and finish up a couple of rods that I'm going to keep forever and pass down to my kids. And we're gonna have some fun, have some hot dogs, and it's gonna be a great event. So I hope this little clip that I'm about to show you, just to give you a better insight of the two cars, and I hope to see you there on Saturday. It's gonna be a great time.
Fading, here today and gone tomorrow.
Okay, this is my 1966 C10 Chevy pickup. When I was 15 years old, I used to cruise Kearney, and on a side street, down next to Kearney Street, there was a Burger King. And three houses down was this pickup truck. It was primer gray with a camper shell. It had the 292 straight six-cylinder in it. It had saw blade tires and wheels, and I thought it was cool, and the guy had said $1,500. I talked my dad into letting me buy it, and I hauled hay all summer to pay off that loan. And I left it like that for a while, and drove it. But about 3 years later, I saved up enough money through mowing and hauling hay to get a paint job. Well, I painted it just gray, like you see here. Took the camper off of it, obviously. Painted it gray. And my friend Joe Kay's mom had a place called the Upholstery Shop. And she did the upholstery. The upholstery's actually pretty nice. It's gray. I added all the pink stuff later on. But it was just this gray upholstery, and I just painted the truck something to match the gray upholstery. Then a couple years later, my friend Shannon Lynn, that was in Karen's class, had a 1970 short wide bed with a 454, and he had a narrowed rear end with an 18.5 Mickey tires on it. He ran off the road, and it scared him. So he talked me into trading me his tires and wheels for my saw blades, and I took it up to the chop shop, Mark Parton. Some inner fenders. These are off a 1982 Chevy pickup truck, these inner fenders. And they actually fit and almost look like they're stock. They're really nice when you clean them up. But those inner fender wheels, along with the natural curve, were able to house 16.5 Mickeys with the narrow rear end. So that's what you see under there. And over the years, I've only driven it since I was 15. I'm 41 now. Probably about 1,000 miles. And I took it to Ozark Square two or three times, to Snow Bluff, cruise Kearney a couple times. Actually, when I took it to Ozark, Cheryl remembers seeing this truck. I got a ticket for excessive spinning of tires when I was a junior in high school with this truck. But that was probably one of the most memorable trips I've had in it. Other than that, it's just been sitting in barns over the last 15 years. And now I come by the good fortune of meeting Jerry here with Starling Enterprise. Jerry knows all.
Yeah, I tell you what, the
paint job on it, do some engine work, make it awesome. So Cheryl and I can go to car shows with the Firebird.
I was 20
the 66 truck there. Underneath, I put a roll pan, got a roll pan off of J.C. Whitney, had it painted to match, put it on there. Put little red dot lights under there.
And I found one exactly like
it
about a year ago, driving down the road. Black, good shape.
The engine right
now. It only had a 383 in it.
396, 375 horse.
You know, good interior.
Big bumper. It's real dirty right now. But it was clean at one point, but that engine, I don't know, we'll see what happens, whether we keep it in there or take it out. I'm gonna let Jerry advise me what the best thing to do is on this thing, but this is, I love these old trucks. My dad and I had a 65, and my dad was with me almost every step of the way on doing stuff on this, so that's another reason I wanna fix it up. It's just to let him see it finished and actually being driven. That'd be pretty cool. Lower down, so about 2 more inches to go. Hey, will it start, Jerry? All right, we'll see. See if it's getting some gas. It will start, man. Just lowering it down even feels different. See, you sit.
Well, yeah, you just sit it down.
Right down. Oh, that's so cool. So that block's holding it up, but even.
Yeah, the block's holding it up 2 inches. When the bags go in there, it'll go all the way. Let's see, I'm going to have to modify this so the pumpkin can go down your floor. I'm going to have to put it in the floor.
Yeah,
for the pumpkin. But it'll go right down there on the ground, man.
That's cool, man. That is so awesome.
But the biggest difference you're going to see between the lowering it and putting that window in there is going to open the truck up. Take the tin off the window so you can see through.
Love it.
And it'll just be...
Can't wait to see what you... Well, I hate to come and run, but we got a show. We got
Gotta get in there and do another show this afternoon.
Like that gas station, come and go.
Come and go. Anyway, Jerry's the man. You've seen the before and after, well, the before pics, but you're gonna see the after pics. Big back window, lower down. It's gonna run like a 8 second quarter.
8 second.
8 second. We'll be right back.